Voice over Internet Protocol, VoIP, is a technology for the transmission of voice over the Internet, and it's a perfect example of disruptive technology for a number of reasons. It has evolved over time, replaced an old technique for a lot of people, changed markets and fields, and led to important improvements. Disruptive technologies or innovations are processes where new groundbreaking products or services are introduced on a much larger scale than before, replacing the old ways of doing things. The concept of disruptive technologies or innovations help us understand how markets are transformed, for example, when new business phone systems are introduced, or how other fields are affected. For example, how new technologies are used to support teaching and learning in schools and at universities. An example of a disruptive innovation is the personal computer, which replaced the old typewriter. The first computers were pretty expensive, but over time and after a sequence of improvements, they become available on a much larger scale and thus accessible for more people. Eventually, the laptop replaced the stationary personal computer, and you could say also that mobile phones have replaced stationary phones, and smartphones have replaced personal computers, laptops, and ordinary mobile phones. Smartphones have also replaced other handheld digital devices such as cameras, MP3 players, calculators, and GPS devices. Emails have replaced ordinary paper letters, and in my field, higher education, we have seen online courses replace a lot of campus education. And there is also a debate whether or not massive open online courses, MOOC, are currently replacing the ordinary smaller online courses. Now, all these disruptors have one thing in common. They have interfered with an old product or service so that something new has become accessible to the masses. In other words, through a disruptive process, a larger part of the population got access to new and better technical solutions and innovative services. Sometimes over your lifespan, you will experience disruptive technologies or innovations. VoIP has been such an experience for me and for many others. VoIP was really introduced during the 1990s and available to the masses in the first decade of the 21st century, at least here where I live in Sweden. In 2014, when my employer decided to change the business phone solution and it was time to toss out my old work phone, I decided to capture the moment as a memento of an era gone by. The old way of communicating via telephone was known as the public switched telephone network, PSTN, also called plain old telephone service, POTS. Basically, the calls were switched back and forth between electrical circuits, and in a sense, there was always a non-stop physical electronic connection between the caller and the person that answered the telephone call. You can picture it as an uninterrupted copper wire with signals going back and forth in a continuous flow. This old technique is being replaced by Internet Protocol, IP telephony, commonly known as Voice over Internet Protocol, VoIP. It's also referred to as Voice over Broadband, VOBB, or Broadband Telephony. Now, regardless of what it's called, this new and disruptive technique uses computer networks and the internet to work. The old way of communicating and the new technique are similar in one sense, though, because they both use digitalization of the analog voice signal. However, the new internet telephones are winning the battle. The difference is that internet telephony, from a technical point of view, is not a continuous electronic connection, and signals are not sent and received in a continuous flow. Rather, they, i.e. our voices, are cut into pieces of digital data and are sent as packages over the internet. A business firm, a university, or any other organization can run its telephone system over the standard internet connection, even a simple broadband connection. In our daily lives, we use internet broadband for emails and for web surfing and other things. And VoIP, well, it's just another service running over the same internet broadband. There are many benefits of VoIP. There are usually no costs for calls between two VoIP phones, which makes long-distance calls less of a budget burden. It is relatively easy to move a VoIP phone to another room or to a completely new geographical location. Simply unplug and move it. As long as you have access to the internet, you will be okay. Now, with the old technology, you had to pay extra for moving or adding a phone, if it was at all possible to do it. And VoIP calls can also be made in different ways, which makes it even more flexible. You can keep and use your old traditional phone together with adapters to hook into the internet and the VoIP system. Or you can use special VoIP phones that are made specifically for using the VoIP system. You can use software on an ordinary computer to make your calls via your PC or Mac. You can even have a VoIP app on your mobile phone. You're not limited by the number of copper wires that run into your business office. You just need one internet connection. And you're only limited by its capacity, i.e. the bandwidth. And as I said earlier, you don't need to pay for and install new copper wire each time you add a phone to your office. The main thing is that your internet connection can handle the calls. If you get problems with the bad sound quality, you can easily change your so-called codec in your VoIP server for better performance. Now, for small businesses, this shouldn't be a problem, but larger employers such as corporations or universities probably need to optimize their VoIP solutions. Another benefit with VoIP is that it's fully compatible with how the internet is set up and operates. And this is great for business phone systems. VoIP works with the existing applications, such as email, web surfing, and customer databases. You can also use your VoIP server to take messages, and you can also send instant messages via your VoIP server. This is the big benefit of VoIP, that telephones and computers now live in the same world. They used to be more or less separated. But now, as they can talk to each other and integrate, it has resulted in tons of benefits for firms, authorities, organizations, as well as individuals. In my example, the hardware is my computer and the headphones. And the software is Microsoft Link, which is a fairly common program for business phone solutions. It's not the only way of using IP telephony, but this type of soft phone is the business solution that my employer has chosen at the moment. A soft phone is software that you install on your PC or Mac to enable your computer to act as a telephone. Well, as I said, it's becoming increasingly more common that businesses are using VoIP systems, and we are currently witnessing the end of an era, and that's why I made this video as a memento. If you want to read more about disruptive innovations, you should check out Clayton Christensen's book and his website, and you can read Dennis Wieland's excellent article if you want to see how the concept of disruptive innovations may be applied to the educational field. Okay, that's the end. Thank you very much for watching this video. Bye-bye.